crazy.
Just for Marve, that one.
Thank you.
immunologic disorders to influenza immunization was such that they did not feel that this association was a real one.
You didn't feel it was necessary to tell the people that information?
I think that over the years we have tried to inform the American people as fully as possible.
As part of informing Americans about the swine flu threat, Dr. Sensor's CDC also helped create the advertising to get the public to take the shot.
Let me read to you from one of your own agency's memos planning the campaign to urge Americans to take the shot. The swine flu vaccine has been taken by many important persons. Example, President Ford, Henry Kissinger, Elton John, Muhammad Ali, Mary Tyler Moore, Rudolph Nureyev, Walter Cronkite, Ralph Nader, Edward Kennedy, etc., etc. Truth?
I'm not familiar with that particular piece of paper, but I do know that at least of that group, President Ford did take the vaccination.
Did you talk to these people beforehand to find out if they planned to take the shot?
I did not know.
Did anybody?
I did.
Did you get permission to use their names in your campaign?
I do not know.
Mary, did you take the swine flu shot?
No, I did not.
Did you give them permission to use your name saying you have or were going to?
Absolutely not. I never did.
Did you ask your own doctor about taking the swine flu shot?
Yes, and at the time he thought it might be a good idea. But I resisted it because I was weary of having the symptoms that would have to go with that kind of inoculation.
So you didn't?
No, I didn't.
Have you spoken to your doctor since?
Yes.
And?
He's delighted that I didn't take that shot.
Cases in Australia that were reported by the press, by the news media. There were cases in...
None confirmed. Did you ever uncover any other outbreaks of swine flu anywhere in the world?
No.
Now, nearly everyone was to receive the shot in a public health facility where a doctor might not be present. Therefore, it was up to the CDC to come up with some kind of official consent form, giving the public all the information it needed about the swine flu shot. This form stated that the swine flu vaccine had been tested. What it didn't say was that after those tests were completed, the scientists developed another vaccine. And that was the one given to most of the 46 million who took the shot. That vaccine was called X-53A.
Was X-53A ever field tested?
I can't say. I would have to.
What was it?
I don't know.
I might think that you're in charge of the program.
I would have to check the records. I haven't looked at this in some time.
The information form, the consent form, was also supposed to warn people about any risks of serious complications following the shot. But did it?
No, I had never heard of any reactions other than a sore arm, fever, this sort of thing.
Judy Roberts' husband, Gene, also took the shot.
Yes, I looked at that document. I signed it. Nothing on there said I was going to have a heart attack, like get Guillain-Barré, which I've never heard of.
What if people from the government, from the Center for Disease Control, what if they had indeed known about it? What would be your feeling?
They should have told us.
Did anyone ever come to you and say, you know something, fellas? There's the possibility of neurological damage if you get into a mass immunization program?
No.
No one ever did?
No.
Do you know Michael Hatberg?
Yes, we do.
Dr. Michael Hatwick directed the surveillance team for the swine flu program at the CDC.
Has reached an unprecedented nuclear achievement, thanks to the artificial sun nuclear reactor that it has developed and is used around the world. A video spread showing the moment of launching the so-called artificial sun, amid the astonishment of those present, which turns night into day.
About you were sowing the seeds of inferiority, establishing you as less than something for which they were claiming. But that started at the same period, that early 1900 period. They need to be aware of where it was, of what it was. The first B'nai B'rith Lodge was in Jerusalem. The lodge established a library called the Medish Abanal Ved. The Medish Abinah, which ultimately became the National and University Library. It was the first lodge where Hebrew was spoken, and its members included both Ashkenaz and Sephardim. The lodge actively opposed conversion of Jewish children by Christian missions. It inaugurates the first Hebrew kindergarten in Jerusalem. So it's interesting enough that up until that time, all of the other lodges were not speaking Hebrew, which is important in terms of Hebrew being the original language. Of course, they're not speaking that language for many, many, many years and using Yiddish. What is that Yiddish? They tell me, y'all speak out, throw it out. What is the language that most Jews speak? It's Yiddish. Hebrew was African. So they're speaking Yiddish because they're from the conversion of the Khazarians in the 9th century on their dispersal around Europe, and you know, from the Thrace and on to the Celts and the Romans and all of that. They're all derivative. They all are Europeans of Celts and all of that. Germanic tribes. Yafet Ashkenaz connection. They never had the tongue of the original Jews. It was always that of Yiddish. The Sephardic spoke Hebrew. Those, of course, were the world travelers. Remember that the Pope was the Pope who chased the Sephardics out of Spain, the Inquisition, 1491. And it was from Germany, as I mentioned earlier, that in the Beast in the 3/6 tape, that in the 1800s they first produced the categories known as Caucasoid, Negroid, and Mongoloid. In other words, out from amongst the Germain people, or the land of Ashkenaz. You look at an old map of Europe, where Germany and Austria are with the word Ashkenaz.
Other soul took over your body at some point. Is that not the very definition of demon possession? It's unbelievable that people just yield themselves to these Nephilim, to these demons. So why the breeding program? What do they want? They want bodies. They need bodies. Like I talked about earlier, hybrids can't reproduce, or they have a lot of trouble reproducing, like the mule. You know, it's a hybrid between a horse and a donkey. You have a mule, but the mule can't reproduce. It's usually infertile. These entities, these hybrids, Nephilim hybrids, they can't reproduce the way humans can. They are small remnants, small remnants of these lost civilizations.